by singing, "I've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb." Amen. I've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. I've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. I've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Filled with the Holy Ghost I am. All my sins are washed away. I've been redeemed. I've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. I've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. I've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Filled with the Holy Ghost I am. All my sins are washed away. I've been redeemed. I've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. I've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. I've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Filled with the Holy Ghost I am. All my sins are washed away. I've been redeemed. I've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. I've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. I've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Name. Amen. Oh, the love of God is flowing, filling all the earth with miracles. The last call has gone out, and the trumpet is about to sound. Those who know God's voice are hearing. Great excitement fills all the earth.
Praise God.
thank you that you are really, truly about to come, Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Oh, I went to the enemy's camp, and I took back what he stole from me. Took back what he stole from me. Took back what he stole from me. Oh, I went to the enemy's camp, and I took back what he stole from me. He's under my feet. Oh, he's under my feet. 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 Satan is under my feet. Oh, I went to the enemy's camp, and I took back what he stole from me. Took back what he stole from me. Took back what he stole from me. Oh, I went to the enemy's camp, and I took back what he stole from me. He's under my feet. Oh, he's under my feet. He's under my feet. He's under my feet. He's under my feet. Oh, he's under my feet. Satan is under my feet. Oh, I went to the enemy's camp, and I took back what he stole from me. Took back what he stole from me. Took back what he stole from me. I went to the enemy's camp, and I took back what he stole from me. He's under my feet. He's under my feet. He's under my feet. Oh, he's under my feet. He's under my feet. He's under my feet. Satan is under my feet. He's under my feet. He's under my feet. He's under my feet. He's under my feet. Oh, he's under my feet. He's under my feet. He's under my feet. Satan is under my feet. Oh, he's under my feet. He's under my feet. He's under my feet. Oh, he's under my feet. He's under my feet. He's under my feet. Satan is under my feet. Satan is under my feet. Amen. Satan is under my feet. Satan is under my feet. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. We thank you that Satan is truly under our feet, Lord Jesus. Amen.
Let your ears listen carefully. Ponder, weigh out, and meditate upon the things that I speak unto you. Beware of those who pretend to be spiritual and yet are tumbleweeds, for they have no roots, and they just tumble from one place to another place. But their roots will intermingle with your fruit-bearing fruit and cause it to be non-fruit-bearing. Beware of those that counsel them that have no wisdom, that have no knowledge, that see not the root of the problem and cannot minister unto it. For there shall be many in these last days, saith your Father God, sent forth by Satan himself to destroy the fruit-bearing vine. Beware of the spiritual tumbleweeds.
Hallelujah.
is it not in the time of the heat of adversity that you need my word the most, saith the Lord? Is that not how you overcome temptation? For there is no other way of victory, saith the Lord, but according to my word. Sometimes, saith the Lord, all you must do is hold on and stand. Believe. And as you trust me, then the avenue opens up for you. Be strengthened, therefore, saith the Lord, in your faith this day, to hold on. Even in the time of adversity, hold on. For I am opening up a door for you. Hold on. Hold on.
Stand and worship the Lord. Amen.
Fill this place with the praise of the God of all grace. Lift him high, glorify the ancient of days. All you saints, lift your voice, lift your hands, and rejoice. God is here, fill this place. This place with the praise of the God of all grace. Lift him high, glorify the ancient of days. All you say, lift your voice, lift your hands, and rejoice. God is here, come fill this place with praise. Fill this place with the praise of the God of all grace. Lift him high, glorify the ancient of days. fill this place with praise. Fill this place with the praise of the God of all grace. Lift him high, glorify the Ancient of Days. All you saints, lift your voice, lift your hands and rejoice. God is here, come and fill this place with praise. All you saints, all you saints, lift your voice, lift your hands and rejoice. God is here, come fill this place with praise. God is here, God is here, come and fill this place with praise. God is here, God is here, come fill this place with praise. Yes, Lord, hallelujah. Yes, Lord, hallelujah. We just lift our praises to you, Lord.
Just praise the Lord for the chains of affliction that are broken when even when we worship him. Amen.
Yes, amen. Hallelujah.
Pastor Dennis.
Yes,
testing, there we go. All right, praise the Lord. If you don't have a pen, please raise your hand. We had somebody this morning who didn't have a pen and he just didn't order anything. I don't want that to happen. We want you to eat. Amen. So if you need a pen, please raise your hand. Amen.
And Dad, while they're passing those slips out, I'm just going to share a praise report here.
Okay.
that came in. I'm just going to pull it up so I can read it to everybody.
Is this the one from the prayer request we had this morning?
Yes, it is.
Okay. This is the one from the prayer request we prayed for this morning. All of you remember that, right? The lady who has come home had 36 hours to live. Amen. Listen to what God did this morning. It's powerful. It's wonderful.
And this was her daughter who would come and ask for prayer, and this is the daughter that's bringing the report. She says the power of God hit Mom and she got right out of bed. They brought her home on a stretcher and she could not stand or walk. She was dancing all around and said she wanted to eat. This woman has no vital organs left, so they say. She wants a drink, saw the cake I just baked and had to eat a piece. She saw my dishes still not done and had to do them up. It was awesome. Then we took her back to the hospital because she wanted them to see what Jesus could do. When the doctor saw her, he ran to her, took her pulse, checked her heart, blood pressure. They cannot believe what they are seeing. They are running more tests now, and I will get back to you, but she got her miracle. Love, Jane from Mississippi.
Praise God. Isn't that wonderful? Huh? You're singing? Is that what Mommy said? Oh. All right. Praise God. Isn't the Lord good? And the brother that was here this morning, he did leave. Brother Samuel, he told me when he left, he says his leg just feels wonderful. He said he knows. He said it feels so much better, and he knows he's gotten his miracle there too. So he just he was rejoicing in the Lord. So I just want you to know that too. Amen. Praise God. He was just very happy. So praise God. Good. Amen. Hallelujah. God's doing great things. Aren't you glad you're here? I am. Amen. I'm glad I'm here. Praise the Lord. All right. Don't forget to put your slips in the... That's for tonight. No, don't just wait. I haven't prayed yet, girl. You're getting too anxious. Father, we thank you for our gift and giver today. We thank you, Father, for all these lovely people. We ask you to bless them abundantly. Amen. Hallelujah. Oh, you want to sing now? Okay, what are you going to sing?
I'm going to sing a different song. Like...
Okay, he wants to sing.
Is it his mom?
I don't know.
Grandma to play for you. Don't hold that up your mouth.
Jesus loves me.
He's still working on me?
Yeah.
He's still working on me? Okay.
He wants to sing, he's still working on me.
Okay, is that too low or is that right?
Working on me. We won't want to be.
They took him just to wait to make the
moon and stars.
Sun and earth and Jupiter and Mark. Loving and patient must be.
He's still working on me. They're working on me
to make me what I want to be. It took them just a week to make
the moon and stars.
Sun and earth and Jupiter and Mars. How loving and patient must be.
They're working on me.
All right, these little ones, sometimes they just get inspired, and you just can't hold them back. They want to sing, so. All right. The Lord gave a stern warning here today, and we might just remind you of all of that. What did he say to beware of? And he told us what a tumbleweed Christian is, so he described it. What's a tumbleweed Christian? They just tumble from place to place. So that's the clue. All right? When you have people that they just, you know, yes. So you kind of know how to identify them, right? That's good. Lord's just saying beware of those because they're...
Beware of those that give counsel to us and don't see the real problem.
Oh, okay. All righty. Amen. Okay. Amen. All right. So, yes, amen. So, amen. Just beware of those, amen, as you, you know, after this thing gets over and we go back, you go back, some of you go back to your regular churches. Why, you know, just beware, amen, throughout the year. The Lord wouldn't tell us if we weren't going to come on our pathway, amen. So we know what to do about it. Praise God. All right. That's good. Praise the Lord. Well, we're just, let's see. Who is singing this afternoon? Are you singing to yourself?
Yep.
Okay. All right. Go ahead.
Praise the Lord. Am I going to have a hard time being right here behind the, in front of the? Okay. All right.
You stay right there, huh?
Yeah, that's. That was my concern.
It sounds like you are.
Okay. We'll move forward a little bit. Yeah. Greetings to everybody this afternoon. You are to be commended for everybody coming out this afternoon. I'd like to read a scripture out of Psalms chapter 27. And then I'm going to sing it. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and they fell. That's a good scripture concerning the Lord Jesus Christ. At the time when they came to take him away to the cross, the enemies stumbled and they fell. Are you the one? I am. And they fell backwards. Though a host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war should rise against me, in this will I be confident. One thing I desire of the Lord, and that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble, he shall hide me in his pavilion. In the secret of his tabernacle, he shall hide me. He shall set me upon a rock. And now shall my head be lifted up above my enemies, round about me. Therefore will I offer in his tabernacle sacrifices of joy, will I sing. Yea, I will sing praises unto the Lord. Hear, O Lord, when I cry with my voice. Have mercy also upon me. Answer me. When thou saidest, seek ye my face, my heart said unto thee, thy face, Lord, will I seek. Hide not thy face from me, put not thy servant away in anger. Thou hast been my help, leave me not, neither forsake me, O God of my salvation. When my father and my mother forsake me, then the Lord will take me up. Teach me thy way, O Lord, and lead me in a plain path because of my enemies. Deliver me not unto the will of my enemies. For false witnesses are risen up against me. See, that goes along with the prophecy. And such as breathe out cruelty. I had fainted unless I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait on the Lord. Be of good courage. He shall strengthen thy heart. Wait, I say, unto the Lord. Amen. I am not afraid. I am not afraid, for the Lord is the strength of my life. He is my life and my salvation. Of whom shall I fear? Yes, I am not afraid. Oh, I am not afraid. For the Lord is the strength of my life. He is my life and my salvation. Of whom shall I fear? Though an army shall encamp against me, my soul shall not fear. When the wicked come upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumble and they fall. Yes, I am not afraid. Oh, I am not afraid, for the Lord is the strength of my life. Yes, He is my light and my salvation. Of whom shall I fear? One thing that I desire and will seek after is to dwell in the house of the Lord, to behold the beauty of my Lord, and to seek Him in His temple. I am not afraid, yes, I am not afraid, for the Lord is the strength of my life. Yes, He is my life and my salvation. Of whom shall I fear? For in the time of trouble He shall hide me in the secret of His tabernacle. He sets me on a rock, my head is lifted up above all the enemy. So I am not afraid, I am not afraid, for the Lord is the strength of my life. Yes, He is my life and my salvation. Of whom shall I fear? Wait on the Lord, be of good courage, He shall strengthen all your heart. You shall see the good of the Lord in the land of the living. So don't be afraid, don't be afraid, for the Lord is the strength of your life. He is your light and your salvation. Of whom shall you fear? The Lord is the strength of your life. The Lord is the strength of your life. The Lord is my strength. Amen. Praise God. Before I get to the title, how many of you remember hearing just recently about the fella who decided to walk across the Niagara Falls? A very quite an endeavor, quite a dangerous endeavor. I didn't get a chance to see it, but I know what it's like when they go across. Boy, oh boy, holding on. Whoa. Did you know that he had to have a word to go across? He had to have permission. If he didn't have permission, he never would have went forth and did something that just seems out of this world, so to speak. I can tell you myself, in the natural, I would never try something like that. But I do want to tell you that faith takes us into the supernatural realm to do things that we would never otherwise do. Faith gives us strength unlike anything else, because faith is from God. Without it, you might as well forget it. You're not going to go anywhere. Title of the message is Fearless Fire or Fearful Faith. And I want you to just think about that for a moment. Now, how many remember the commercial on television? It was pretty popular. I'm thinking it was in the 70s, maybe 80s, about two little boys deciding what they were going to do concerning this little box of cereal. I'm not going to eat it. You eat it. Yeah, Mikey. I'm not going to eat it. You eat it. You try it. Finally, Mikey decided to try it. And that cereal, of course, was called Life. And he liked it. The Bible does tell us, taste and see that the Lord is good. Amen. And today I want to tell you that Peter is like Mikey. He's watching Jesus do all these wonderful things. The Lord has shown him all these wonderful things. You know, I mean, he's telling him, you know, go back out and go fishing. Huh, you got to be kidding. Fishing all night? But because you said it, Lord, so I'll do. And so he went out and found out if you obey the word of the Lord, something supernatural will take place. Hallelujah. And so here we got Peter. He's something. And Jesus comes walking on the water one day. Walking on the water. Supernatural power. That was awesome. And that really got Peter excited. He wanted to be like Mikey and said, I want to try that. Lord, if really that's you, bid me to come and walk out on the water. The Lord said, come. And so he began to walk fearlessly because he received the word that gave him faith. He believed in the Lord and began to walk right on the water. Pretty powerful thing. But then something began to happen. The winds blew. The waves began to rise up. Trouble seemed to rise up. Isn't it true that in this world there's a lot of trouble, trial, tribulation, a lot of difficulty? And the question will be is, will we endure that? Or will we get afraid? And the next thing you know, help me, Lord! His faith went into fear. Ah. God did not give us a spirit of fear. With power, love, and a sound mind. Amen? Amen? Peter got picked on so much in the Bible. But you know what? We learn from him. We learn from the things he made mistakes with and his successes. How many remember the story when the Lord says, Who do you think I am? Who am I? You remember that? And they all began to say who others said who he was. But he says, who do you think I am? Do you realize you need a word from the Father in heaven by the Spirit so that you know the truth? Without that, it's called a rhema word. You're just going to sit there. You know, you're really not going to know what to say. But Peter heard the word of the Lord. And he said, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. He just boldly said it. And he got blessed by the Lord, didn't he? And the Lord complimented him. But Randy's getting ahead of my message. But that's all right. That's good. Just shortly after, then we ran into a little bit of a problem. The Lord said, and he was showing his fearlessness, the fearlessness of our Savior. I'm going to have to go to Jerusalem, and I'm going to suffer many things, and I'm going to die. That's an awful thing, and I'm sure all the disciples are like, whoa. Well, what happens is if we don't stay in that realm of faith, we become fearful, and what happens is we rebuke the Lord. Peter rebuked the Lord. And I wonder sometimes when we become fearful, are we rebuking the Lord? Ah, that's a dangerous place to be. Amen? a dangerous place to be. What happened? Jesus had to rebuke Peter. Now, how many of you have ever been rebuked? Few hands, not too many. Oh, few shakes of the head. Do you realize love is understood by rebuke? So often, if we don't speak out, and it is a rebuke, but it's love. I'm going to use you for example, Pastor Evans. Pastor Evans is a challenger, all right? He used to fight the bad fight of fists once upon a time in his life, but now he fights the good fight of faith. Amen. He ran into someone who was also undefeated, but he didn't knock him out with the fist. Jesus knocked him out with his love. Love brings you right to your knees. You know, down for the count to submission. And quite often what I love about him so much is he will bring forth a challenge to you considering your thinking. And if you're not thinking according to the Word of God, you can't see the full picture. And I believe Jesus was a lot like that too. Constantly challenging the disciples to see in a greater realm rather than the natural realm that they were always so used to seeing. And so he would challenge them. And how many times we heard this, "Oh, ye of little faith. You're not using your faith. You're not believing what I'm saying to you. And you're just really having fear." Did God give us a spirit of fear? Absolutely not. But we face fearful situations in this life that we have. Now, let's just talk about the Bible for a moment. Abraham, God called him, sending him to a place he's never seen before. A little fearful. Just a little bit fearful. But I want you to see something here. What was his strength? The Word. God spoke to him. Faith rose in his heart. So he was willing to go someplace he's never gone before. And of course, it was very interesting on his way. He was with his family. But there came a time when he had to separate in that time. And as Stephen tells us in the word that he spoke in Acts chapter 7, his father died, allowing him to go and fulfill the plan that God had for him. But we know the stories about Abraham, don't we? There were some things that was fearful for him. And because of that, he made some decisions sometimes that wasn't full of faith. But because he kept believing the Word, God's grace was there. When you believe the Word, there's grace. And God gives you a chance to improve upon those mistakes. Hallelujah. And have a second chance, if you will. Because there's no second chance once our Lord comes. That time of grace will come to an end, and then judgment will take place. Amen. And when that takes place, we will either be rewarded or we'll be cursed. Amen. Amen. All right. So we see the Word of God revealing so many things. But Jesus, he had fearless faith. What was it? How did he get it? He sought the Lord. He sought him in his temple. He sought him in his pavilion. He constantly began to seek the Lord at all times. We need to continue to seek the Lord so that we have strength for every day. And I want you to know something. Having a meeting after meeting after meeting teaches us to do that. Amen? Amen. We're here today. We're dealing with different things. But we should not be moved by those things. Amen? No matter what the situation is. I've heard a lot of stories of different things that people are going through, but isn't perseverance what it's all about? Amen. And you get from point A to point B to point C. Amen? And you want to avoid going around and around and around. You want to continue to move forward. Paul, in the Bible, first called Saul. If anybody knew the word of God, it was Saul. He knew it from cover to cover for what they had in that day. He was a powerful. But he didn't know the God of the Bible. Because he didn't know the God of the Bible, he made a lot of foolish mistakes. And the scripture says, the foolish shall not stand in the pleasures of the land. Hallelujah. And he was one that was falling. And God tried to get his attention through someone like Stephen, who was full of the Holy Ghost, full of the Spirit of God. But he kicked against the pricks. He kicked against being grafted in. He did not listen. So as a result, God had to knock him down because God had a plan for his life. Amen. Now here's a man that he was fearless, but fearless in foolishness. Fearless in foolishness. Let me tell your story. Before I got saved, I was foolish. Oh boy, was I ever foolish. I used to do a lot of foolish things. One of the most foolish things I ever did was try to do a backflip, landing on my head when it was all said and done. My father was there, my brothers were there, my wife were there, and they all said, don't do it. I didn't hear a word from God. I was only going by my word. And when I did that backflip, I hit hard. My head hit the metal, took my hair out, bit my tongue, and down I go in the water, and watch, this is what it was like. That's how I went in the water. But I was still alive. And down there, I said to myself, I gotta get up to let people know that I'm still alive. When I came up, they pulled me out. My tongue was a mess. My hair was sitting down there. And then, I can't remember if we were married or not, but we weren't married. My wife showed me a scripture in the Bible. Thank you, Lord. Not to put the Lord to a foolish test. I didn't have a word from God, so I was doing my own thing. And that day, once I understood that, I made a decision. No more. No more of this foolishness. I've got to know what the Word of God is telling me to do. See, God wants us to have fearless faith. So let's talk about Paul just a little bit longer. When he was getting saved, amen, because he got blinded, and God brought Ananias to open his eyes and bring healing to his eyes after he was blinded. All this time the Lord was speaking to him. And the Lord told Ananias, you know, he was afraid. Here comes this guy that is, you know, he's going to come and cause trouble. He said, don't be afraid. He's going to suffer for my sake. He's going to suffer for doing, but I've called him to reveal my light to the Gentiles. So here comes Paul. And glory to God. He gets the light. And the man became fearless because he got to know the God of the Word. Amen. And because he got to know the God of the Word, he began to do things that others, it was unbelievable. They would begin to attack him at times, throw stones at him because he was speaking the truth. That's a pretty powerful thing when you think about it. Are we willing to stand even if the world stands against us in unbelief? Amen. He was so fearless. He went through all kinds of things. The scriptures talk about whippings and different kinds of things. But he would not give up. He was fearless. There came a time when he decided he was going to go to Jerusalem. Now you know this story. And you know a prophet began to speak to him and tell him, you know, don't do it, man. This is what's going to happen if you go. And others did too. Don't do it. But you know, I want you to know something. Paul was not afraid. Amen. And it's a good thing that he was not, because he wouldn't have survived his little trip to Jerusalem. He would not have survived his little trip to Jerusalem. When he went and he wanted to bring forth the word of God, next thing you know, they wanted to get him into the law. But there's three things that act as like a surfboard for us in this world. Revelation chapter 12, verse 11. They overcame them by the blood of the Lamb. They overcome the enemy by the blood of the Lamb, the word of the testimony, and they love not their lives unto the death. Are we willing to stand for the gospel no matter what the cost is? See, that's the decision we have to make. No matter what the cost, are we willing no matter what? Are you willing? Amen. Hallelujah. Good. It's good. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, did they have fear or did they have faith? They had faith. They had the word of God. No matter how bad it was presented unto them, they made a decision. We will not bow to no statue. We will not bow to any law. No matter what, we're going to follow the Lord. And as a result, they were able to go into that fiery furnace, believing God. And the Lord brought them through. God is going to bring us through. No matter how hard it gets in these days ahead. No matter how hard the waves of adversity come. That's why I talked about the Word of God being like a surfboard. Because you ever see somebody on a surfboard, the waves of adversity coming against them, and they've got to be able to do it a certain way on that surfboard, otherwise they're going to get wiped out. And that's why I call that our surfboard according to the Scriptures in Revelation 12:11. They overcame by the blood of the Lamb, the word of their testimony, and they loved not their lives unto death. They were fearless. And that's the way we need to be, fearless. We're going to be in situations in the days ahead that are going to be sticky. What do I mean by that? That means there are going to be a lot of people at different times that are not going to like what we stand for. We're going to hear things from others that will try to deter our faith. And I'm being serious about this now. Are we going to use the fearless fire that God has given unto us? Are we going to continue to hear the word of God? Or will we succumb to the lie of the enemy? Going to hear the word of the Lord, right? The word of the Lord brings refreshing. Without that word, it would be difficult to stand. Are you willing to stand if you're not hearing the word of the Lord? But are you willing to stand until the next word comes? That's the point I'm trying to make. Are you going to continue to believe until the next word comes? That's important. The reason why I say this, because the enemy is a trickster. All right? And because the enemy is a trickster, there's going to be times when it seems like nothing is happening. Nothing. You feel nothing. You see nothing. Nothing seems to be happening. Will you still believe the word? Until the word of victory comes. I thank God right now for the atmosphere that's in this place right now. Why? There's parts of it the Lord is showing me very uncomfortable. But you know what? Am I willing to still trust the Lord? Yes. Am I willing to still stand on His word? Thank you, Lord. Am I willing to still believe like Abraham after 25 years the promise finally came? Can I use you, sister? Here's a sister from Auburn. Yes. Believing God to do a work in Auburn. Not seeing things, but believing, knowing the word, building herself up, and will not give up until there is a breakthrough. That's real Christianity. Amen. That is real Christianity. God, make me fiery. Yes, all of it is so good, but are we still willing to stand on God's word? Are we willing? I think of Paul and Silas. They were fearless. and they ended up in jail. Did they give up when they were in jail? They started to praise the Lord. There we go. And as they praised the Lord, God moved on their behalf. See, how we're going to respond to the circumstances. Faith is creative. There's been a lot of people that have been in difficult times where finances were getting low. What are we going to do? God is saying, seek me. Seek my face, and I will speak to you. And if you'll listen, he will direct you one step at a time. There was a time when my finances were really hurting. And I made some foolish mistakes, and that's why they were hurting. But God took me one step at a time to get out of that mess. I was in debt, unbelievable debt. I owed more than what I was making per year. That's not a good place to be. But God began to speak to me to do this, to do this. And you know what? I had to do it faithfully. Faithfully. And it was against my grain of doing things. You see, sometimes we've got to do things that are totally against our grain of thinking. We would never do it. It's uncomfortable. But if we're willing to trust the Lord in the most uncomfortable places, God will bring us through. God will give us a breakthrough. Amen. I think of Dave and some of the testimonies that he was giving concerning his own body. And the way he made it sound like it was unbelievably impossible to happen, but he kept standing on the word. He kept standing on the word in the time of adversity. See, God wants real seekers, real standers, real believers. And if you're willing to do that, you will get a breakthrough. I don't know what somebody's going through here today. I don't know the trial, the adversity, the difficulty. But I want you to know that nothing's impossible with God. Amen. With man, it's impossible. But with God, all things are possible. Amen. My wife will attest to that. As she's seen different things that the Lord has given unto us that she thought would possibly never happen. But God is able. But are we willing to hold on to the faith that he's given unto us? You know, sometimes faith is powerful. It's charged. And I'm sure it was like Randy this morning. Zoom! But you know, sometimes faith is like a knot that all we can do is hang on to. Hanging on to. The boat is moving all over. You know, it is tough. Nothing's going right. All you can do is hold on. You know, and begin to pray, Lord, help us. Help us until he calms the sea. Amen. I'm sure I'm speaking to somebody today. But I want you to know the word of God is true. God came into my life in 1982, 30 years ago. I asked him to come in. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He will not leave us, and he will not forsake us. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. And I want you to know that God is going to reward you for holding on. The breakthrough is just ahead. Amen. I believe there are people right now that are feeling like they ought to give up. It's impossible to them. Is it really going to work? I want to encourage you today, hold on, because the breakthrough is just ahead. Don't give up. Hold on to God, and he will bring you through. He will bring you through. God has called every Christian to be fearless. Faith is what makes us fearless. Faith helps us walk on the water. Faith helps us to not give up. Thank you, Lord. What's the purpose of the kingdom of darkness? To get us to give up. Today we're hearing psychology being spoken right over the television and political arenas to try to get the believer to give up. And they're trying to unite these people that they call believers. But they're not believers. They're trying to get a one world religion where we can all just gather together and say we believe the same thing, which is the biggest lie perpetuated from the kingdom of darkness on every side of hell. But I tell you what, it's a lie. Capital L, capital I, capital E. There's only one thing that brings peace to the believer. And that is a relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. And that is the very thing they reject, is a relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, I'm about as sober looking, sober feeling as you can imagine. But boy, when the Spirit hits me, I can be just so full of joy. But you know, it's not always like that in the Christian walk, is it? That's what we need to understand. It is joy, unspeakable and full of glory. It is the joy that goeth before us. But sometimes we're not always super smiling. We're not always laughing. Sometimes we need a serious talk about things. Kind of, if I could use it this way, dead serious about the faith that we're putting our, you know, the word that we're putting our faith in. Dead serious. No matter what. You know what it does? It makes you strong. Amen. It makes you stronger. Hanging on, even if everything says don't hang on. God wants to see. Let me put it this way. This has been a good time in this place. But when we go home, are we surrounded all the time by all the believers keeping us strong? Not always, are we? Ah, that's where the rubber meets the road. That's when obedience really counts. That's where we make a decision about the television. We make a decision about the friends we keep. We make a decision about the thoughts we think. We make the right decision, we're going to see great miracles in the days ahead. Amen. Wrong decision, we'll see nothing. I thank the Lord for the feeling that we have in this place. Amen. Keep your eyes upon Him. Throw off every weight that easily besets you. Amen. Throw off every weight. Anything that would keep your faith from being strong. Hold on to that word. Don't let it go. Keep your eyes on Jesus, who for the joy set before Him endured the cross. You know, the Lord went through a time like this. Wow. He went through a time when it seemed like nothing was happening. Couldn't feel the strength. He was in the Garden of Gethsemane and couldn't even get his best friends to stick with him. He had asked them to pray, but he felt the agony of what he was about to have to endure. But he did not give up. He had his focus on what God had called him to do, and that was what? To take away the sins of the world. And even before he got to the cross, as he just held on to the Lord, the very sweat drops that came from him were his blood. Right then, he was already pouring out his love for us. The most difficult time. But it is in that time, and it's to what we're feeling right now, it is right before the great victory. Amen. And as he continued to pray, He finally got it. Lord, not my will, but your will be done. Amen. Not my will, but your will be done. He got the strength. And let me tell you, how many know he needed strength? Because wicked men took a hold of Jesus. And boy, oh boy, you know what the scriptures talk about. Plucked his beard, smit him on the face, and you know the lashings that he took upon his body was unbelievable. Unbelievable. There might be somebody today that might be thinking, you can't imagine what I have gone through. You don't know. Jesus knows. Because you can't imagine or know what the Lord endured for you. He kept a heart of forgiveness even though mankind was hurling insults at him. Never did anybody any harm, but hurled insults at him. Come against him, and they were relentless, mocking him, putting that crown of thorns on him. And here he is, the King of Heaven. The whole world should have been, you know, but he came for a purpose. He came for a reason. He was willing to die on the cross. Why was he willing? Because there was something that was separating us from God, and that was sin. And he had to take that sin upon himself and offer himself as the Lamb of God. Amen. Despised, everything put upon him. I've never preached a sermon like this before. But we need to recognize all that the Lord endured so that we understand, and there's a smile from my face, that we're willing to endure. Amen. Because we will never endure anything that the Lord had to endure. Some of the little bit of difficulty that we go through in life is nothing compared to the glory that we're going to be able to have with our Lord Jesus Christ. So I want to encourage you today, don't give up. Don't give up. Don't give up for others. Don't give up your faith for others. Because as we continue to go forward, listen to this. There's going to be a supernatural work of God upon the earth. And God is going to begin to open minds and open hearts and cause them to recognize we who are going still forth for God. God is going to give, in this last revival, people one more chance. And if they'll take that opportunity and seek the Lord out, God will save them. That's why we got to continue to go forth, to go forward in the faith that God's given unto us. Not just for ourselves, but for the sake of others. That's fearless fire. That is fearless fire. You know, when we consider the soldiers, our young men who have gone, as well as older men, have gone across seas and have given their lives for the sake of the country, are we willing to have that same attitude concerning our testimony? Amen. Are we willing to still have that attitude for the sake of the testimony? The testimony of Jesus Christ is the spirit of prophecy. Revelation chapter 19, verse 10. Prophecy gives us permission to do the work of God. And I want you to think about that. Prophecy gives us permission to do the work of God. Why was Jesus able to do it? Because it was prophesied about. It gave him the permission to do it because God spoke it through his prophets. Prophecy gives us permission to do the will of God. Could you say it with me? Because I love to have that ingrained in your heart. Prophecy gives us permission to do the will of God. You know, you read about it in the book of Corinthians, to seek the greater gifts, and prophecy being a super great one. Why? Because of the permission that is granted unto us to do the will of God. God is prophesying through his people. And again, the rubber's meeting the road. He's telling us it's our responsibility to rise up and do it. We don't need another word. You know, we don't have to go seeking after another word. The word is clear. We need to go. Not just the logos that we read in the word, but it has been spoken unto us, unto the church, to go. Go ye into all the world. Amen. Make disciples. Make disciples. Hallelujah. Like that one song goes, he is calling you. He is calling you. He is calling you. Amen. All right. I thank the Lord for what he's doing. Brother, could you help me bring this back? We're not done here today. But I would like to initiate by the Spirit a time of seeking the Lord.
Yes, amen. Thank you, Lord.
A healthy seeking the Lord Jesus Christ. Whether you stand or kneel, this is a holy place. This is the altar of Almighty God. I'm opening up to seek the Lord for direction, to seek the Lord for strength. They that wait on the Lord, God will give them strength. And it's the music of heaven that's playing. We don't need an organ, do we? Seek the Lord while he may be found. This is a difficult time to seek the Lord because you may not see nothing, feel nothing. Little action. Are you willing to seek the Lord even in the midst of nothing happening? Seek the Lord. Seek the Lord.
Where can I go from your presence, Lord? If I climb to the highest mountain,
because I am a prayer warrior.
Or if I go down to the lowest parts of the earth, you are there.
And I'm going to seek.
And if I find myself in the most remote part of the world, even there, your glorious, comforting right hand will lead me.
God,
you are here with us now, Lord. We thank you. May our praise rise up before you as sweet incense before your throne. And precious Holy Father, may our praise be an act of relationship between a father and his child, between a man and his God.
We seek your face, Lord.
The Lord reigns. He is a mighty God.
For ourselves.
The Lord God.
But we also seek you, Lord. For the sake of your kingdom.
The Lord.
For the sake of lost souls.
He is a mighty God, the Lord God.
We have everything we have to give, Lord. But we come here still yet to seek you.
Great is the Lord Almighty.
Great the powers of darkness.
He is God
indeed. That is coming against the house of God.
Great is the Lord Almighty.
Break him in the
God
name of Jesus.
Supreme. Great is the Lord Almighty. He is Lord. He is God indeed.
He created heaven and earth.
Great is the Lord.
Great. jealous God who intensely loves his creation.
You may have thought that worship was simply our expression
and is not willing that any should perish.
But worship is so much more than us just singing to him or even about him. Worship also means God expressing his heart back to us. Are you listening?
Thank you, Lord, that we're able
what
to
is he
overcome
saying to
by
you right
precious
now?
Blood.
Our Father's desire
for
you,
Lord,
is that you would know how much delight he takes in your presence.
It cleared the way.
Now, I love to sing songs of peace and comfort over my own children in the night.
Songwriter,
and I'm an earthly father.
It has cleared the way.
So how much more our Heavenly Father loves to sing over us. God's word, according to Zephaniah 3:17, says this: For the Lord your God is with you.
Open avenues.
He is mighty to save.
For those that, Lord, you are calling into your kingdom. We're praying for lit paths. We pray it for hearing where we are now in this state, throughout the state, throughout the East Coast, that your word, Father, will go forth right now. And only the way that, Lord, you can transport your word.
To you alone may my spirit yield.
To reach those lives, Lord, because the time is so short that if they don't get a word from God, they'll perish. And we're praying right now for a word. No matter where they're located. And I'm seeing some pretty ugly scenes. Muddy pits. Dirty places. God, that your word will reach those hearts and those lives. That you might show them the way, Lord. And that, Lord, the harvest, that you will bring forth a laborer unto them. We are crying out for grandchildren, great-grandchildren, sons, daughters, uncles, aunts, moms, dads, nephews, nieces, strangers. As little Jordan told me yesterday in children's church, God loves the stranger too. Pray for your grace, Lord God. Your grace, Lord God. Avenue for it. Opportunity for it. Because if we don't seek you,
you're my friend and you are my brother, even though.
Let your light, Lord God, shine upon the continents. You know where the souls are. Strengthen, Lord, your people. That every believer would be like a missionary in their situation. Bringing forth the word of God in your situation. To save the lost. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for the anointing you brought into this place today. Destroy the yoke. Satan's bondages are broken. We declare it to be so. Because we're praying. And God is sending his word because we're praying. And that the angels be loosed to do the work of God, to bring the word of God, to charge the soldiers of God. Because the time is almost up. God is in the soul business. Hear my words. God is in the soul business. And every day there are souls going to hell. Do we like that? If you don't like souls going to hell, seek the Lord. Seek the Lord.
I'm so glad you came to save.
Cry out to you.
You came from heaven to earth to show the way. From the earth,
praise you, Lord.
Across my dead.
We pray for your holiness to spread across the land for the conviction of souls. Lead us to them as well. You know how you want it to be done, Lord.
Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life.
Somebody has a prayer. Don't be afraid. Like that. Tomorrow we know we will live. Let us seek the Lord that others may have life too. Draw them out, Lord Jesus. Draw them out of Hollywood, if you will. Draw them out, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Best. I will sing and make music.
I will praise you.
Draw them out of the bars and the porno clubs. The businesses that tax. Draw them out, Lord. Draw them out of the homosexual communities. Draw them out, Lord. Draw them away from the abortion clinics. Draw them out. That's to our shame, you know. That's to our shame. But we're praying. Draw them out.